You know where you are? You're on the East Side Dave Show, baby! You're going down! To a very special edition of the East Side Dave Show. And yeah! Today I'm right back into it because we have such a jam-packed show for you tonight. We don't have any time to waste. Yeah! Literally. David, throwing it over to you, the Mr. Master of Ceremonies. Take it away, my friend.
Yeah! Yeah! East Side Dave, you're East so Side handsome. Dave. East Side Dave, you're East so Side handsome. Dave.
Roy Harter with the most mediocre introduction I've ever heard, man. And thank you so much. But we do look nice and handsome in our matching coats. Oh, everyone has been saying we look like a couple of, like a crackhead version of the Supremes is what people are saying. We look like
Siegfried and Roy.
It's fantastic. And it's a very special East Side Dave Show with Roy Harter episode where we are going to get to the bottom of aliens, Area 51. And I'm going to explain that I'm going to explain my childhood psychedelic vision of humanity, Mars, the origin of our species.
Oh, that sounds wonderful,
Dave. And I will solve the mysteries of the universe and will reveal to you my vision that I had as a child. And but you know, Roy, before we do that, gratuitous talk show monologue. You want some?
David.
You want some?
I want some, David.
You want some gratuitous talk show monologue, dick? Sorry about that last part, Roy. I don't know why I lashed out at you. Robert Durst, star of The Jinx and Hall of Fame killer, has died at the age of 78. They're saying Durst died peacefully in his sleep, unlike the four chicks he murdered.
Kill them all.
Not Limp Bizkit. Don't you make a Limp Bizkit joke, you motherfucker.
Fair enough.
That's all I saw on Twitter was 9,000 Limp Bizkit jokes.
I know. Sorry about those.
That was like one of the first true crime things. And then Netflix just went all crazy with the true crime shit.
Who knows?
Did you watch that one?
I did, actually.
Never mind. The New York Yankees named a woman to manage one of their minor league teams, a first in MLB history. And the lady manager is already changing some baseball jargon around. From now on, ball girls will be referred to as testicle women, and bunts will simply be called cunts. Maybe like that.
Good rule.
He's got a cunt going on. It's a 3-1-2nd and third. He's gonna do a call with a suicide cunt. He's got a suicide cunt. Here comes the real son. He's safe. He's safe. He's safe for the suicide cunts. Yes,
I'm pretty sure my ex-girlfriend was a suicide cunt.
Fox Sports put out the early Super Bowl odds for every playoff team. The Packers and the Chiefs have the best odds to win it all. As far as the Giants, they didn't even make the playoffs because they suck harder than Lisa Ann during a gangbang. Wow. Roy Harter's favorite. He told that to me one time off the air.
That's right.
And I'm dining him out right now.
All right.
Lisa Ann. You are into Lisa Ann and sometimes a Lisa Ann DP video. True or false?
A DP video, I'm going to say false.
The women's wrestler Matilda the Hun has died at the age of 73. Matilda was in the Gorgeous Ladies of Wrestling League, where she was known for never breaking kayfabe, always sticking to her gimmick. For instance, after Matilda the Hun won a match, she liked to cut out her opponent's clitoris to keep it as a trophy. It's a little I mean, you don't want to break kayfabe, but, you know, she wasn't an actual hun. She didn't need to be, you know, cutting out clits, is all I'm saying.
Above and beyond.
Yeah. I do respect the commitment to her gimmick. I will. The website YouSwitch has created a list of the most boring movies of the past 20 years, based on audience reviews. The Last Airbender is the most boring film, followed by Annabelle. In related news, the same website also ranked the most action-packed shows with the cast that is most likely to kill you at number one, The East Side Edge. Music! And my God, but wait, you hit it already. You hit it a long time ago, I think. Yes. Because what you're about to experience is not a radio show, is it, Robert?
No, it's not a radio show, Dave.
It's not a radio show.
Come on.
How stupid. How stupid can somebody be?
Pretty stupid, David.
And it's not a television show, is it, Robert?
Come on, Dave. Who would have us on?
Who the hell would have us on, for crying out loud? We're not a television show. So what are we about to experience here, Robert?
You're about to experience the East Side Dave Show!
East Side Dave Show! With Roy Harter! All right, Roy. You ready?
Two, three.
I wish you love and happiness. I guess I wish you all the best. I wish you don't do like I do and never fall in love with someone like you. Cause if you fell just like I did, you'd probably walk around like a little kid. But kids don't know, they can only guess how hard it is to wish you happiness. Really harder! Like a Christmas tree, you decorate a tree, you throw it in the yard. If the casein dies and the snowman melt, well, I once knew love, knew how low fell. Yeah, I knew love, love knew me. When I walk with love, love walk with me. And I got no hate, and I got no pride. Got so much love, I cannot hide. Roy Harter!
Here we go, David. Last time.
They drive a Chevy, so you drive a Ford. You drive around town till you just get bored. Then you change your mind, something else to do. And your heart gets bored, your mind changes you. With love, no shame, it's an awful mess. I wish you love, wish you happiness. I wish you love, I wish you happiness. I guess I wish you all the best. I wish you love, wish you happiness. I guess I wish you all the best. Yes! 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 Come on, Roy! We gotta tell him again, Roy Harter!
Roy!
Yes! Roy! Wow, sounds like a natural in here.
Yeah, I never got one of those before, David.
I gotta really quickly give you an update about my road rage.
Oh, yeah.
It's now extended to police officers.
I don't foresee any problems there, David.
As you know, I work a morning radio show, and there's a rule in my town, which is that if it snows, even in the middle of the fucking night, if your car isn't gone by the time the snowplow comes, you get a goddamn ticket.
That's it, yeah.
Here's the thing, Roy. I always park on the street because I get up for work. I leave at 5 a.m., right?
You're an early morning guy.
So, I get up 5 a.m., and there's a cop just sitting in his car. Double parked.
Waiting for you, huh?
I get in my car. Roll down the window. Yeah. Can I help you, officer? Here's a ticket. What's this for? The snow plow.
You're just
your car's in the street. I go, it's 5 a.m. The snow plow hasn't arrived. There is no danger of my car obstructing the snow plow because I'm out of here. I'm in the car. I'm driving to work.
Yeah.
It's 5 a.m, officer. And you know what he says? Gotta hand you the ticket anyway. And so this is my mistake. I go, I've known the chief of police for 30 goddamn years. 30 goddamn years. Which is not a lie. The chief of police was my basketball coach. And so I know the chief of police for 30 goddamn years.
Okay.
And, but Dad, still, I'm yelling at this 28-year-old police officer. I know the chief of police, motherfucker! For 30 goddamn years, he's gonna hear about this.
You have his badge.
So, yeah. So then I called up the court, and I said, I demand a court date. This was yesterday.
Wait a minute, you called up the court?
I called up the court.
I didn't know you were even allowed to do that.
I have the ticket. I
he
called up
the chief
court.
Of police.
Yeah.
He can do what he wants.
Oh, you're right. Good point.
I called up the court, and I said, I demand a court date. I demand to represent myself in court because it's 5 a.m. So last night, about 11:30, after eating several 75 THC MG caramels, got so goddamn paranoid that I was convinced that the court date was a setup for my inevitable arrest. Positive.
Definitely paranoid.
100% positive.
Wow.
So I went over to, the court today and I said, I'm just going to pay the ticket, and I'd like to apologize to Officer Murphy for that outburst over there. So my road rage now extending to police officers. You're Stevie's applauding.
Stevie loves that.
This is not good, Robert.
One thing I like to ask cops in those situations is, who do you think you're serving or protecting right now?
It is the truth, though. Look, straight up, and I'm not. This is not an anti-cop rant. Okay, we're just chilling.
Yeah.
But this is an anti-fairness fucking thing. I'm in the car. Yes. Okay, you know, and the fucking ticket's not on my windshield.
No,
he was writing all the cars on our block. But the point is, the guy who goes to his car at 5 a.m, you can rip that one up and get all those other fucking cars a ticket, and you can rip up mine and say, "Okay, be on your way. You're out of here," because the snowplow hadn't come yet.
Unbelievable!
It's bullshit.
Unbelievable!
God damn it!
Dave,
Stevie,
next time maybe you just ask him, like, hey, don't you got any, like, young black kids to go shoot or something? Officer?
Right. You know? I just said. Is it an anti-police rant, Steve?
Derek Chauvin, what are you doing out of custody?
Let me explain one other thing that set me off.
Uh-oh.
And I'm sorry, but I can't help it. I walked into the post office. I had to pay my rent.
Sons of bitches.
Here we go again. Oh, boy, David.
I am now going to call the two guys who work in behind the fucking counter, and I'm giving, I think someone on Twitter, one of the East Side Davidians, one of the 50,000 East Side Davidians out there, a member of our cult, they brought this up, and it's a great one. These guys, they sound like, no, they are middle-aged Beavis and Butthead. Not only do they kind of look like them, but because of their musical tastes. Roy, this is true. Hand to God, give me 30 lie detector tests. I go into the fucking goddamn post office, where the post office guys, in case you don't know, they know I work on 95.9 The Rat, legendary rock station in New Jersey, where I am the co-host of the Morning Rat Race, number one ratings. And they talk to me about the music that we play. I have no control.
Of course not.
On-air people have no fucking control.
No control whatsoever.
Okay, you talk to a goddamn program director or musical director about that type of shit, okay? Yeah. I go in today.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you guys play more Iron Maiden?
Oh, well, they... Oh.
And less Rolling Stones.
Well, I may have to agree with him.
No, you fucking don't. I knew you were going to fucking make this hard on me. But you just sit there and shut your mouth. I'm all for wanting a little more Bruce Dickinson and Iron Maiden.
Hell yeah.
But to fucking call out the Rolling Stones. with these fucking guys. Every fucking time I'm at the goddamn post office, they need to tell me the bands that, and they're all 80s metal bands. They want more Quiet Riot, and they don't like bands such as Nirvana. And they, you know, they want the Motley Crue. But God forbid if we play Pink fucking Floyd. Iron Maiden, more Iron Maiden, less Rolling Stones. Less Rolling Stones, less you, motherfucker! Yeah. You're on the Shizer!
Shizer!
You're the one that we despise!
And you're staying on the Shizer list for quite some time. I will just find a new post office to mail my box of dildos. I don't need you. I don't need to always go to you. Roy pointed it out.
Yeah.
I'm just stubborn because that's my post office. That's my town post office. I feel like if I go somewhere else, they're pushing me out of town. But these motherfuckers.
Fucking Maiden metalheads, man. They'll do it every time. You should,
Dave, next time you say to the guys, don't you got some young black kids to go shoot or something? Yeah. Yeah, it works every time in my book.
I don't think that's necessary.
Stevie, do you have some young black kids to go shoot?
Roy, yeah, David, there's a news story that caught my attention.
Uh-oh.
Katy Perry has come out with a line of sparkling non-alcoholic drinks. And these drinks will offer benefits like brightening a mood or helping one relax. Shock Jock Robot is here to comment about these new goddamn drinks. What the f- Shock Jock Robot, everybody! Hi, Shock Jock Robot, how are you? You'd be better if Katy Perry's shark dancer bit my legs off. Okay, that's fine. Anyway, did you hear about Katy Perry selling drinks that put you in a better mood? You hear about that? You mean like booze, he says. That's true, Ed. Says that shit's been around forever. It's the only way he was able to fuck Rosie from the Jetsons. Okay, Shock Jock. He got her. He got Rosie from the Jetsons drunk. There she is. She does have a nice. Shock Jock Robot, let's not go. So, what else? Did I know that Katy Perry is into being suffocated by a pirate? What do you mean? She routinely chokes on Orlando Bloom's dick.
Oh!
This is going into a sexist area that I don't like, Shock Jock Robot. See, what? You thought Katy Perry was a two-time Golden Globe winner until you realized you were just looking at her titties in a yellow dress. Chauvinistic.
Yikes.
Pig, you're sexist. This is chauvinistic talk, Shock Jock Robot. Huh? What's the difference between a fuck doll and Katy Perry? The fuck doll won't make you listen to her album after you jizz in her. Okay.
Oh.
Like, really inappropriate, Shock Jock Robot. I don't... Huh? Like she said in her song, Katy Perry has the eye of a tiger. A really big-breasted tiger who has shit for brains. Okay, Shock Jock Robot.
Oh, that was...
That was too much.
Bit much.
That was too much. You belong in the 1990s, Shock Jock Robot. Not in today's era. Yes.
Robert. It feels like he says the things I'm thinking.
Yeah.
Shock Jock Robot has that. You do have that reputation, don't you? Don't you? I'm talking to you. Don't be fucking you now. I'm sure you got your goddamn fingers over there. Do we have Bo on the line? A special, No, we don't. Bo, I want to. We sent an emergency communication to you because it's been announced by the New York Football Giants. Breaking news: our shitty, goddamn fuckball of a head coach, Joe Judge, has been fired, and that is good for Giants fans such as you and me. We are both Giants fans, Bo. I want your reaction. I want to know what you think about the Giants organization. John Mara, who I feel, Bo, is a cowardly owner, but at least he did the right thing by firing Joe Judge today. Bo, come on. Talk to me here.
Well, I think he should.
What?
I agree.
He should sell the team.
John Mara should sell the team. That's probably not going to happen. But what do you think about Joe Judge getting fired? What do you think about that?
I'm glad. It's a bad time. The season stunk.
Oh. Okay. He's hitting hard right now. He's hitting hard.
Yeah.
You, what are you, on a budget or something with your words? you know. What are you, Hemingway over there? No goddamn adjectives? What is this, old man in the sea?
This whole season stunk.
Okay.
Freaking coach that made probably the dumbest coaching decision I've ever seen in the history of the National Football League.
Okay, what? Which was?
Last Sunday.
Last Sunday. When
he called that quarterback sneak.
On 3rd and 9.
Twice in a row.
Yeah, I know. On second down and on 3rd and 9, on 2nd and 3rd and 9. Okay, that's a concern. Okay, so a quarterback sneak is when you're 6 inches away from a first down. You just have the quarterback get the hike from the center and take a step. It's 3rd and 9, and as you can see, he quarterback sneaks for 9 fucking yards. By the way, he did that on 2nd down as well. And see, Roy, here's why Joe Judge was a cowardly chicken pussy. Because on 2nd down and 3rd down, you have 2 downs. You could actually pick up a fucking 1st down. Run the ball, pass the ball, get 5 yards on 2nd down, get 4 yards on 3rd down. Guess what? You have a fucking 1st down.
Huh.
You know, quarterback sneak, he was saying we were playing for the punt on 2nd down.
Dave, on that,
he playing said for the punt.
They had gotten sacked, you know, for a safety the week before. That's why.
I don't fucking care.
What, do you have post-traumatic stress from a fucking safety? Yeah. Like, you play on.
Also, it's about understanding where you are in the season. They were 4-12. You go for shit. Your season's done. You go for everything.
Or you quick kick on 3rd down. How cool would that have been?
That's just as crazy. Bo, what do you think about John Mara, the Giants owner?
He's aging too. He's aging out of being an owner.
He's aging out. Bo, we're going to do some quick hits. What do you think about Dave Gellman, the general manager, being allowed to retire rather than getting fired? I was hoping he'd get fired, but they allowed him to retire, which pissed me off. What do you think about that, Bo? Quick hits.
I think the mayors were off his rocker. He should have been fired right there on the spot. The moment the season turned to shit, he should have been fired.
Bo's on fire now. What do you think about Joe Judge going forward? Will he ever get another head coaching job? Let's go. Quick hits.
I'm pretty sure he will never get a head coaching job.
Give me some quick hit music real quick. I got some quick hits for him.
Coach a beer league team.
What do you think about Daniel Jones' future on the New York Football Giants? Is he going to remain the starting quarterback, or is he done as well? Quick hits. Let's go.
He could possibly get.
Well, that's a wow. That's a wow. I can barely hear a quick hit.
He'll get one more here.
Bo, are you attracted to men? Quick hits. Let's go. Quick hits. Yes. Quick hits. Are you attracted to men? Quick hits. Let's go.
All right, ready.
Are you attracted to men?
I didn't hear what you said.
Stop playing for a second. Are you attracted to men? Quick hits. Let's go. Stop stonewalling me.
I am straight.
Okay, Bo. Are you attracted to animals? Quick hits. Let's go.
Nope, I'm not.
If you had to make out with Roy or Stevie, who are you making out with? Let's go. Quick hits.
If I'm going to have to go that route, I probably would just...
Oh, fuck.
You got to choose one. Oh, he said Stevie?
Yeah.
What? Okay, would you let Robert jerk you off for $1,000? Quick hits, let's go.
Yes, I would, because I need the money.
All right, Bo with the quick hits. Awesome. We're going to let you... Oh, wait a second. Robert said he had something about Bo here.
So, apparently, Bo's in love with somebody? I don't know if you heard this, Dave.
What?
Oh!
Bo's in love?
Wait a minute, is that true?
There was this fat pig who, I guess, got hit up by the Bachelorette.
Jesus, Robert.
And then the producers ghosted her because she was so overweight. And
really?
So, Bo kind of addressed at the end of her video. She said she was still interested in marriage, and I think
can we
Bo
see this?
Submitted
can
a little something.
Can we see this lady?
Do we have her? We're looking her up now, David. I'm on it.
What's Bo? I'm so excited. You're in love. I feel really good about this, Val. Oh, yeah. Here she is. Oh, she seems.
And I'm normal. I'm an average size. I'm just not a size 0, 2, or even a West Caroline for Bachelorette. But also, if you want to get married, I am a very cool person.
I think that video is dubbed.
Wait, here we go.
I've been really trying.
Oh, wow. Bo likes her, huh?
Hey, babe, it's Bo. Bo, star of the world famous East Side Dave show with Roy Harter. I just want to let you know that I don't mind if you're a big honker that smells like bacon when you rub your thighs together. Let me take you by the hand and show you what it means to be loved. I'll cover my dick with stuffing and gravy and let you go on top and let you go to town. You can stop by Dunkin' Donuts for a snack for
the fuck, Bo.
You can stop by for Dunkin' Donuts for a snack first and some 2 donuts. The best news is, I don't mind being at home. I'm pretty strong from working at UPS. And I wouldn't want you to squash me. The best news is, I don't mind being at home. Being on top all the time. I can't wait to tell my mom. I can't wait. Fuck you harder than the Blasio's fucked over this city. Alright, and that's it.
Bobo! And his quest for love. Wow. I'm not sure if that's gonna work. That might get you a fiance or a restraining order from her.
I just love his voice.
I guess what was that? That was your
sexy voice.
Your Barry White. So wearing the same clothes, by the way, in the video as you are right now.
I might have filmed that video earlier today.
You did, huh? Oh. You did you?
Yeah.
Okay. Where are you? By the way, you look like you're in a closet. You fucking weirdo.
In the closet, Dave.
I'm at home.
You're at home.
It's my recording studio.
You're at home. Okay. Any posters on the wall or anything like that? Or
No, there isn't anything right now.
Let's just say, Bo, when are you coming in next, Bo? We miss you here. Oh, by the way, Bo.
Oh.
Bo. Bo, hold on for a second. Hold on. I will let you know that Big A, Andrew Gold, where is he? We love Andrew.
Yeah. I don't know, David. I'm not gonna jump to any conclusion.
Well, where is he?
Oh,
because I'd love to have Andrew and Bo back in the studio, having their epic rivalry once again. Robert, do you know where Andrew is?
Yeah, I asked Big A where he's been the past 2 weeks,
and
he said he couldn't get over Luby's cunt stench.
Oh, my God.
So I don't know what that meant or why he would feel that strongly.
That hysterical, but...
I have no opinion on that at all, Dave. Thanks.
Wow.
That's a quote from Big A. I don't know why he said that.
I don't smell anything.
And that's coming from Big A, huh?
I hope not. Okay, Bo, it was great having you. Yeah. I'm going to let you go.
Great way to end it.
Great way to end it. So can I give you my childhood thing here? I am going to blow your mind. I think.
Oh, you've already blown my mind.
Give me some alien music here.
Alien music, okay. My specialty.
You son of a bitch.
Specialty music, David.
Because I recently had this dream it's the first time I've had this dream since I was a child. And this dream is more of a vision. And it's pretty clear that I have figured out the mysteries of the universe.
Dave wins again.
Since I was a child, I've been fascinated with outer space, including Mars, for that matter. And when I was a kid, I had a very distinct theory. I had forgotten about it until just recently. Okay, I won't tell you how the memory got jogged out of my head, but someone said, remember that theory? I saw one of my childhood friends I hadn't seen in about 30 years, and he told me about my theory, and I'd forgotten it. And then I realized, oh my God, that theory's dead on. Mars, the red planet. How'd it get like that, huh? Huh?
God.
You don't know?
God, don't know.
Not God. Nuclear Holocaust.
Whoa. Whoa.
From who? From a civilization of human-type organisms for over, let's say, a million years ago. While Mars was getting blown up by these, we'll call them humans, over a million years ago, some of the more technologically advanced, richer, more civilized humans, Martians, were able to escape the planet. Okay? Through the years of their technology advancing, they were able to travel to planet Earth, where they were able to put their own seeds on our planet.
Whoa!
Human beings are Martians.
Whoa!
What?
What? No what? We didn't evolve, I'm sorry to tell you, from Jesus, from Allah. We came from Mars. Hold it. Hold the phone. Who are these UFOs that we're currently seeing now? Why are they visiting us? The government has footage of UFOs. We have the Pentagon video from 2017. Those are the intergalactic humans who are now time travelers visiting us to make sure we are on the right path and not another nuclear Holocaust path. Which would explain why in World War II the sightings of UFOs amped up around United States, Russian, and German military bases. Because the UFOs wanted to ensure that we did not once again blow ourselves up. So when you see UFOs in the sky, they're humans. And when you see Roy Harter and Davey Mack right here, we're Martians, motherfucker. Oh, yeah. And that's my theory. Now I want to tell you something. I've had this theory. This is true. I had this as a child. This was a vision I got as a kid.
Okay.
I recently was watching Ancient Aliens on the History Channel.
Right.
And guess whose fucking theory popped up on the goddamn show?
I'm going to go with
Transpermia
yours.
Is now a new goddamn... Where'd my fucking billion Whoa. Music go, brah?
I thought you were done, David.
Hell no.
All right, just getting started, huh?
Where? Did I see this Transpermia thing on Ancient Aliens? I'm not saying they ripped me off. What I'm saying is, what if this knowledge is encoded in all of our DNA? That one day we will all wake up and realize we're Martians, and that we did not originate from the planet Earth. I've reached out, thank you. I've reached out to Giorgio Tsoukalos. I've also reached out to David Childress, two leading ufologists. I have not heard back from them. I did give them my entire theory in written form, so I probably scared them off. Huh. They probably think I'm either joking or I'm just a all-around jerk-off. Because probably, this entire diatribe, I actually sent them via email.
They're probably ripping your idea off, Davey Mack. They're probably trying to publish it right now.
Something's
That's why they're
going
not responding.
On. I have tried to book them for this program. I want to tell them my theory. I want to see if I'm right. So Giorgio Tsoukalos and or David Childress, if you're watching, you have a friend in East Side.
Yeah, we'll get them a clip. We'll get it over to them.
Now that's my brilliant conspiracy theory, but that's not all. I have demanded that each cast member of the East Side Dave show give a conspiracy theory of their own. It's going to be called East Side Dave Show Conspiracy Theory Roundtable.
Very nice.
And we're going to begin. Robert, you have a microphone already in your hand, so I'd like you to begin and tell us one Robert-type conspiracy theory. You've heard mine. We're Martians.
Well, I'm not going to do the obvious one, which is that Andrea is a lesbian.
Oh, that's not a conspiracy theory.
I mean, yeah, that's
uncomfortable. But the one I am going to do it is I haven't ever heard of anybody dying of skin cancer before they invented sunscreen. Like, I think skin cancer comes from putting sunscreen on your skin, and it gives you skin cancer, and it's all big sunscreen keeping the business going.
It's not a bad thought. I'm going to tell you why. Guess who got skin cancer on his fucking head? Me. Guess
me too,
who's been watching? Guess who's been putting fucking copper tone on his stupid ass head since he was a fucking baby? Me. I've been putting copper tone on my head since I was a baby, and I got skin cancer right fucking there!
No.
Thank you, Robert. Robert's conspiracy theory. I'm into it. Steven, do you have any conspiracy theory?
Oh, yeah, Dave. All right, this one's a triple conspiracy that goes deep in throughout the halls of Compound Media.
Yeah, I love this.
The first part is that Flutesy can't actually play the flute.
Oh, Jesus.
That's actually the booth piping in the live flute sound whenever she's been in studio at home, that someone else playing the flute.
That's possible.
The second one, I think that Bobo is actually a genius. Oh. Like a Mensa level genius. He's playing us all.
He's been fooling us all.
We're the fools.
Yep. I'm the fool.
And
you got me, Bo. You got me.
This is
I'm the fool, Bo. You got me.
And the third one, the final, most devious one, is that Big A stutter is not real.
Big A stutter is fake! My mind is pop. Okay? Pop. What? Yeah, like that.
That is wild.
Roy? Or Andrea? Do you have anything?
Yeah, Helen Keller.
Helen Keller?
Yeah, everyone, history remembers her as, this genius. But, how could someone who's blind and deaf absorb any information, let alone communicate it?
Well,
her teacher
I'm not sure
was
if
making
history
shit up.
Remembers Helen Keller as a genius. I mean, I, for one...
Ascension.
No, I, for one, know Helen Keller's favorite convenience store. Wah, wah!
Classic.
Roy, do you have a conspiracy theory?
I sure do, David. I believe that Eric Clapton...
Oh, God.
...is a serial killer.
Oh!
That's right, David.
Talk to me. This is interesting.
If you think about it, he killed his son to get a hit song.
Oh,
damn.
That's Tears in Heaven. His little boy fell out the window.
That's
right. Very sad, actually.
Fell.
And he also killed Jim Morrison.
What?
Jimi Hendrix.
Kurt Cobain?
Janis Joplin, because he was jealous of their talent and fame. Because, let's face it, he's a pretty basic guitar player.
Whoa! What about Stevie Ray Vaughan? Did he kill him too?
He may have. Now that you mention it.
He tampered with the plane? He tampered with Stevie Ray's plane?
He might have stuck a fucking screwdriver in that helicopter. Oh, no, it was a plane.
I don't think, Garrett,
he also shot the sheriff, Roy.
See that?
That's a good point.
You guys have anything, or... No.
I mean, I don't know if you guys can handle... World War II.
Oh, Garrett's got a conspiracy theory.
Horrible people did horrible things.
Well, that is true, Roy. He's onto something with that.
Well, let's hear where he's going with this first, because I'm not sold quite yet.
Well, just because they were your uncle and grandfather doesn't mean what Garrett is saying is wrong. Your German uncle and grandfather is what I'm trying to say.
The most horrible people did concentration camps. And you have to be so horrible to run those. Those horrible people killed everyone, but they saved a few. Probably the Jewish women with the best boobs.
Oh my God.
And that's why Jewish women have the greatest boobs.
There is so much wrong with what you just said. Not even Shock Jock Robot would mix Holocaust and breast size. Drew. No, Drew's out. And so ends Eastside Dave Show Conspiracy Theory.
I feel like I'm tripping.
I know, that was disturbing, right? I am shocked about Garrett's conspiracy theory. I mean, that just broke the fuck. I don't think Giorgio Tsoukalos or David Childress are going to call me back after hearing that. I'll tell you that much right now.
Cut that part out.
What was I going to... Oh, Robert and Stevie were going to... something about the Area 51 or
something? Sure, yeah. We'll do some improv for you, Dave.
They're going to do some improv. Robert and Stevie, because today's show, today's theme is about UFOs, aliens, extraterrestrial life. And Stephen and Robert have prepared a little something to capitalize on that. Roy, are you a believer in UFOs? I mean, what about the 2017 Pentagon footage there?
Have you
seen it?
I have not seen
the one with the Tic Tac.
Definitely not seen that, but I...
UFO released by the United States government, the Pentagon, said, this is a fucking UFO. It's going probably 20,000 miles an hour or some shit. Here it is.
And it was a Tic Tac.
It was on, you know, in the New York Times. This wasn't some bullshit fucking tabloid.
Okay. Well, like I said, I believe UFOs. So if it's out there, yeah, it's out there. And I'm sure the Pentagon has a lead in on that story, as they say.
All right.
All right, Stevie and Rob, ready to do some improv. All right, first thing we need, a location. What's that, Dave? You want us to be at Area 51?
Area 51.
Thank you.
Let's
and
do
what
Area
are we
51.
Doing? We need
since
to do something.
I said it.
All right, Andrea, we're covering up the conspiracy. Okay, right, Stevie, take it away.
Conspiracy, like no, like scary.
Oh,
UFO.
I know. Out there, everybody's been hearing all these stories about these aliens, illegal aliens. In New Mexico, that's your problem, folks. It's actually the illegal aliens that's the problem. They're not actual aliens.
That's right, folks. It's New Mexico, not Mexico. So y'all just worry about keeping the Mexicans in Mexico. Don't worry about any aliens here.
That's right.
All right. Listen, we work for the government, okay? The government, people. When has the government ever lied to you about anything, okay? We are your friends. We have your best interest at heart. Stevie?
That's the truth, Bob. Bush didn't do 9/11. The Bay of Pigs is just actually a barbecue restaurant. And Iran-Contra was a video game.
That right. And that pedo bitch left us hanging in Benghazi. We'd never do anything bad.
A lot of folks have been saying that the truth is out there. They're looking for the truth. They want answers, right? Well, I actually have the truth right here, folks. We got the truth. It says that Flutie is really annoying, but she's got a nice ass.
You want a real truth? Looks are fading and acting talents have not developed yet.
Oh, God damn it.
Listen, I've heard talk that people saw an alien, okay? I've heard the description of the alien. It's tall, like freakishly tall and lanky. And bald, okay? You guys have just seen Stevie Lou. It's Stevie.
Oh, jeez.
I'm not bald. I'm going bald.
Get it right.
It's different.
Wait, are you outside of Area 51 right there, guys?
Yeah, we are.
You are?
Yeah.
I see some wreckage and some aliens.
Nothing to see here, Dave. Nothing to see here, Dave.
There's wreckage behind you.
Listen, if you think that we're in Area 51, the folks out there, we're going to take your mom to Area 69.
Oh,
that's right. We're going to deep space explore pussy, Dave.
This is offensive.
All right. I guess we got one final point. We'll say this one last thing. I just got to say that if anyone out there thinks they're seeing aliens, it's more likely you've just gotten your hands on my high-grade California marijuana.
That's right. And we will be selling it after the show. $200 an ounce. Oh, so hit up Stevie Lou.
I want some of that.
No aliens. Buy Stevie Lou's weed.
Okay.
Thank you, guys.
Put me down for an order of that hydro grade stuff that you were talking about. That was insane.
It sure was, David.
What do you think about that?
I couldn't really hear it over my sci-fi music. I'm sorry.
You know, we haven't talked to you in a while.
Yeah, what do you want to talk about?
Well, man? You know, you're always supposed to be prepared.
Yeah,
with,
you want to hear a good story?
Well, I mean, we all like to hear about what's going on in Roy's life.
All right. Well, I could be telling you what
well,
I'm
Well, how about the jingle first? This is Roy's life.
Wow. All right, David. Well, I could tell you about some work I've been doing, but I could.
We want something that's entertaining, yeah. A story, so that you're contributing.
Good idea.
To
all right.
The show.
Well, let me tell you a prostitute story. How's that sound, David?
Whoa!
All right, I knew this would work.
Prostitute story.
All right. Anyway, so there was a time. Now you knew. I think you knew this. Where I lived in Budapest for, I guess it was almost a year, right?
Right.
I was about 22 years old.
He used to be a world traveler. This guy.
I used
guy.
To live
you
in the Hotel Panorama. This is, by the way, this is a god. On my life, a true story, every word of it. So I used to live in the Hotel Panorama in Budapest, right?
Yes!
And they used to have a club up there. This is 1991, called the Hully Gully Club. And it was a very strange club because, well, first of all, they had just converted from communism, so it was like almost like a free-for-all for the Eastern Europeans. One rule about the Hully Gully Club, no Africans allowed. True story.
Okay.
Wouldn't allow Africans
Where
in.
Where is he going?
Anyway.
Andrea's applauding.
One day, I go up to the Hully Gully Club, and they have a world-famous DJ coming up, right?
Yeah.
Hotel Panorama, Roy.
Hotel Panorama is right.
Oh, so that's a code word. Go ahead.
They asked me, because they knew I had some experience with the electronics side of things, hey, we got a guy coming over with some CDs. Can you help us hook up this CD player?
Uh-huh.
I was like, of course, I'll be happy to help you. Now, as payment, I helped them set up the... I forgot the DJ's name. As a payment, the manager of the Hully Gully Club said to me, I'm not gonna give you any money, but why don't you take one of these girls home?
What?
Right? So
what is this story?
So listen to this, David. So
okay, are you confessing something?
So
wait. Can I just say, does it sound like he's going to a? He's confessing to like a
sounds
fucking
like a
big time crime.
It's like a film noir.
Yeah.
Sort of
so
plot.
It, not
this
quite.
Is,
not,
I'm hard.
Not quite. But anyway, so I pick one of these girls, and we're having a drink at the. This is when I was drinking, by the way. So evening comes around, and it's like, okay, you know what? Let's go back to my chalet, right? So I take this prostitute into the into the taxi. We go back to my chalet, and it was a bit of a walk. As I'm walking to my chalet down this winding road, I run into my actual girlfriend at the time, who sees me arm in arm with this prostitute going to my room. And of course, as you can imagine, she was, 19 years old, and she flips out, right? And I'm like caught with like a deer in the fucking headlights with this I don't know Eastern European whore. So I start mumbling and like stammering as I do when I feel the pressure.
Yes.
And so I said to this, as this girl is screaming at me, flipping out, I said to the prostitute, I go, listen, can you leave? And, I'm really sorry, but this is not going to work. She demands payment before she leaves.
You got to pay.
So I said, this has already been taken care of. The guys, you were my gift. So she says, no, I need taxi fare to get back to the club, to the Hully Gully. So I ended up paying this prostitute to basically leave me the fuck alone. And of course, and I ended up still staying with my girlfriend at the time.
Really?
Believe it or not, I talked my way out of that one, David.
Is that's the story?
God, honest to God, true story. Okay, on my life.
I know, but that's like some sort of weird psychedelic confession that you just did on the show. I was just looking to see what you're up to.
I thought that was too boring, so I figured let me reach back into my bag of tricks. Was that a?
I guess so.
Yeah.
I guess.
All right, that's all I got right now, David. Sorry.
Think of, during the course of a week, if something happens to you.
Okay.
Think about it, remember it, and then bring it in for Tuesday.
All right, maybe next time. All right, no more prostitute stories, David.
No!
Why?
I enjoyed the prostitute story.
Do you have
but
more
make it prostitute stories? Yeah, I mean, it should be a modern prostitute story. It should be like a prostitute story that happened to you like last week.
Like a Pretty Woman type of thing? See, that's the problem. I don't have any prostitute stories within the past 20 fucking years.
Well, then we got to play Roy Harter, Truth or BS.
Okay, fair
enough.
And
you do that.
That we can do.
This is Roy's life. It's a modern day journal of what you're up to.
Oh.
Whereas Roy Harter, Truth or BS, is more akin to what you just did, which is nonsensical rambling for 9 minutes.
No, it's true story, David. True story.
I know it's true story. That's why it was so goddamn boring.
Dave, I think you should. I think you should cut Roy some slack on his hooker story. His Flutzy hasn't been on the show in almost 2 years.
Oh, you guys are destroying that poor woman. You guys have talked about Flutzy 7 or 8 goddamn times today.
I have a natural rivalry.
Are you aware what she's going through?
Definitely.
Did you know about this? She's suffering gangrene right now. Did you hear about this?
No. I did actually.
She's suffering through gangrene. She might lose the right leg.
I don't want to say.
We're not supposed to say it happened. She was swimming in a pool with bacteria in the Bronx.
Yeah.
I fucking told her don't go to that public YMCA. It went into the goddamn thing and into the toe, and she said even maybe the right pussy area.
Yeah, staph infection.
She might lose a leg now because of it. Mm-hmm. That's what's going on. I fucking got you, Stevie! I fucking got you! Oh, that was good!
It's the left leg, you idiot.
My heart
Did I just get you?
I was about to start crying on air.
Yeah. What goddamn year? It's not the Civil War, Stevie. Gangrene! Gangrene, Stevie. The couch butt for a split second. That was good. I felt like fucking Joe Pesci and Goodfellas there.
Can you body paint a fake leg? I was worried for her.
She could definitely do like a green thing. Yeah. Like, oh, I got gangrene. Oh, she should do like her right breast with green. Oh, my dick got gangrene. My dick gonna fall off. I miss Flutzy.
We do.
I miss Andrew.
Yeah, I know. Sorry, Andrew.
Does he realize he hurts me? When he gives the cold shoulder, I just always like to make sure that he's okay.
I feel like he's angry at one of us for some
reason.
It's
not me. I didn't do a goddamn thing. Plus, he said Happy New Year to me and Happy this and Happy that. And I said the same thing to him, so he's not mad at me. I know that for a fact.
He just messaged me, Dave, and said maybe Luby should worry less about who's in the studio and more about her biological clock.
Oh, God damn it. He's upset at Luby, is what Andrew is. I don't know why.
She's not here.
She seems nice. She's Croatian.
Oh, yeah. Rose, she's awesome. Luby's the best.
Right?
Yeah.
But she's not here right now.
Andrew seems angry with her. I don't know where these messages are coming from.
Andrew, please, don't be harassing Luby. She's from Croatia. Okay.
Montenegro
is a province in Croatia, I believe.
Albania, actually, Dave.
All
Albania.
I know is that there's fucking bombs and always people with masks and machine guns.
Very close to Budapest.
Dark camouflage. Not the good, happy American green kind, but like dark camouflage. Scary. Scary.
You know,
fucking
by the way,
you
know what my horse's name was?
It's like hostile over there. What?
It was Lubo. I'm serious. I still remember her name.
Roy.
Can I say, Dave, we need Big A, if anything, just who's going to ask Billy Mitchell questions when he comes
Thank
on.
You.
You know what I mean?
No, like, I love Andrew.
At the very least,
I know he's not mad at me.
We need you for that.
Okay, you're right. Andrew, whoever you're mad at, we apologize for them. I know he's not mad at me, but we want you back. Okay, please. And Big A, Andrew, go. This is a request. Next Tuesday.
Wow.
Thank you very much.
Dave, that was good.
Thank you. All right, let's get out of here.
All right, David.
I got some mescaline to eat. And then I'm going to watch The Book of Boba Fett. There were 2 fucking Hutts and an evil Wookiee in the last episode. And yet I'm still seeing some Star Wars pussy fans upset. There's a new goddamn division of Star Wars fans who I fucking hate. And it's just crybaby assholes that hate everything about Star Wars. Stop watching Star Wars! This new Boba Fett series has been amazing! We're gonna talk to Cheap Baby about it next goddamn week is what we're gonna do. And not just that, but some of the movies of 2021 as well. Some of the best of movies. Alright? Did you watch that Don't Look Up on Netflix?
I sure did, David.
Did you?
Didn't like it. Didn't like it.
Really?
Yeah, I looked down.
I thought it was a great movie.
Let's talk about it next week, David. I really hated it.
God damn you. Damn, it's been a real fine day. And damn, it's been a real fine day. Ain't got the blues, ain't got time for bad news. Damn, it's been a real fine day. Damn, it's been a real fine day.
Long Island to West LA. No need to worry, cause I ain't in no hurry. Damn, it's been a real fine day. There's a whole lot of trouble out in this world, yes, a whole lot of worry, whole lot of worry. Now that I had you come into my life, there's a whole lot of reason to say, damn, it's been a real fine day. And damn, it's been a real fine day. Got on my new shoes, ain't no way for blues. Ha! Cause damn, it's been a real fine day.